وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد إن شاء الله تعالى today we're going to take the last and final point that we intended for the نواقض of شهادة أن لا إله إلا الله we've already taken ولله الحمد والمنة the virtues of لا إله إلا الله we also took the conditions that a person needs to come with before they come with La ilaha illallah, prerequisites, shurut. And also, walillahi alhamdu wal minna, we spoke about the meaning and the pillars of La ilaha illallah together. We mentioned that the pillars of La ilaha illallah are affirmation and negation. That we affirm for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ibadah alone, and we negate it from everything other than Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So those four topics we've taken, we've tackled, and I hope we understood them all inshallah wa ta'ala. Now, bi-idhnillahi al-kareem, we're going to go into nawaqid, things that nullify a person's la ilaha illallah. Very dangerous, you need to stay away from it, and it can nullify your la ilaha illallah. It destroys your la ilaha illallah. And so, inshallah ta'ala, when I mention the nawaqid, I'm mentioning it from two perspectives. The first perspective is, as Allah mentions, وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلِتَسْتَبِينَ سَبِيلُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ The people that come with these nullifiers are the criminals. The people who choose not to come with what La ilaha illallah means. Rather, they want to come with its opposite. So I'm trying to clarify the path of the criminals, the wrongdoers. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala from the bottom of my heart that Allah protects me and all of you from this path. Very dangerous, and we should always be worried and concerned that our La ilaha illallah, are we coming with things that are going to nullify it? This is something we should be scared about, consistently be worried about. Now, brothers and sisters, think about this. Ibrahim alayhi salam is a prophet of Allah. And Ibrahim, as we know, is from the five chosen prophets, from the Ulul Azmi min al-Rusul, from the five chosen prophets. Ibrahim, who we know from a young age, fought against shirk and even destroyed the idols of his father and his people. At a very old age in his life, Ibrahim alayhi salam specifically asks Allah to protect him from something that he knew when he was a child, which is, He said, رَبِّ جُنُوبِنِي وَبَنِيَّ أَنَّعْبُدَ الْأَصْنَامِ He said, Oh Allah, protect me and my progeny, my offspring. Oh Allah, protect them from worshipping idols. He's not saying, Oh Allah, protect my children and my offspring from doing shirk, because shirk comes in different forms. He's asking Allah to protect him from the most common, the most well-known form of shirk, which is idol worshipping, which he knew it from a very young age. He begged Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to protect him from it. And we even know in the Qur'an that when Ibrahim alayhi salam was on his last moments of his life, he gave a farewell to his children. Allah mentions to us in the Qur'an, وَمَنْ يَرْغَبُ عَمْ مِلَّةَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ إِلَّا مَنْ سَفِهَ نَفْسَهُ وَلَقَدِ اصْطَفَيْنَاهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَإِنَّهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ لَمِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ إذ قال له ربه أسلم قال أسلمت لرب العالمين فوصى بها إبراهيم بنيه ويعقوب يا بني إن الله اصطفى لكم دينا فلا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون He's advising his children die in a state of submission be muwahideen come with tawhid stay away from that which will destroy it and Allah mentions this about Ibrahim عليه السلام and Ibrahim we all know it He was a muwahid, as Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said, مَا كَانَ إِبْرَاهِيمُ يَهُودِيًّا وَلَا نَصْرَانِيًّا وَلَكِنْ كَانَ حَنِيفًا مُسْلِمًا وَلَمْ يَكُمْ مِنَ الْمُشْرِكِينَ So if Ibrahim was scared of shirk and worried about shirk and concerned about it, then it wallahi is something we should all be worried about, scared about. No one's safe from it. الْقُلُوبُ بَيْنَ أُصْبُعَيْنِ مِنْ أَصَابِعِ الرَّحْمَنِ يُقَلِّبُهَا كَيْفَ يَشَاءُ The hearts of the people are between the two fingers of Allah. Allah tosses and turns it the way He wishes, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we need to learn this part so we can stay away from it. The first reason is وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلِتَسْتَبِينَ سَبِيلُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ And then the second reason why I'm mentioning it is from the angle of what the Arab poet said عَرَفْتُ الشَّرِّ لَا لِلشَّرِّ وَلَكِنْ لِتَوَقِّيهِ وَمَنْ لَا يَعْرِفِ الشَّرَّ مِنَ النَّاسِ يَقَعْ فِيهِ أَمَا مِنَ الْخَيْرِ يَقَعْ فِيهِ Mentioned in those different ways. The poet said, "Araftu sharra," I came to know about the evil. I studied the evil. Okay? Reason I did this is because I want to stay away from it. It's taken from the hadith in Sahihain, min hadith Hudhayfa ibn al-Yaman. كان الناس يسألون رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم عن الخير وكنت أسأله عن الشر مخافة أن يدركني. That the people used to ask the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم about the good. I, on the other hand, used to ask about the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم regarding the evil and the bad things. The reason I did that was مخافة أن يدركني. I was scared and I was worried and I was concerned about this happening to me. So inshallah ta'ala, from those two perspectives, the first one was وَكَذَلِكَ نُفَصِّلُ الْآيَاتِ وَلِتَسْتَبِينَ سَبِيلُ الْمُجْرِمِينَ. We're mentioning this so the path of the criminals and the wrongdoers becomes clear. That you know this path is the path of the criminals. This is the path of the mushrikeen, the idol worshippers, the people who haven't really understood Tawheed, which we ask Allah not to make us from it. And we're worried and we're concerned for ourselves as well. And the second, inshallah ta'ala, reason why I mentioned in the nawaqid of La ilaha illallah is what? If you know the evil, and you study the evil, and you come to know the evil, it will help you and aid you to stay away from it. It's a means to know, stay away from it. For yourself, for your own self. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he nurtured his companions upon this way, alayhi salatu wa sallam. He did, alayhi salatu wa sallam. He taught them the importance of learning that which is problematic in order to stay away from it. He nurtured them upon that, alayhi salatu wa sallam. Hudhayfa mentioned that statement of his, where he would ask the Prophet about the evil, and the Prophet would consent to that, would allow him to ask those questions. And because he knew Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu had a good motive and a good reason behind it. Even Umar ibn al-Khattab, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu ta'ala anhu, used to say, إِنَّمَا تُنْقَضُ عُرَى الْإِسْلَامِ عُرْوَةً عُرْوَةً إِذَا نَشَأَ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ مَنْ لَا يَعْرِفِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. Islam will be destroyed bit by bit, piece by piece. It'll be taken down in piece by piece. Who would destroy it? لكن إِذَا نَشَأَ فِي الْإِسْلَامِ مَنْ لَا يَعْرِفِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ. That is, if in Islam, a person grows in Islam who doesn't really know about the jahiliyyah, he doesn't know about the evil, he only knows good, that person can bring harm to the religion. So knowing the evil is a way to abstain from it. Inshallah ta'ala, I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala that he gives us the strength and the knowledge and the ability to stay away from those which destroy Allah ilaha illallah. Allah protect us from it, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before I go in, I want to say something. I want this, inshallah ta'ala, be something all of you remember. It's very important, brothers and sisters. Three points I want you to all remember, inshallah ta'ala. It was something I wanted to mention when I was explaining the meaning of La ilaha illallah. And that is, there are three things you need to come with. Three pillars, remember that. Always remember that. When we're talking about La ilaha illallah, there are three pillars that need to be there. Okay, three pillars. Okay, or three core things. Because I don't want to say pillar, because pillar can be the nafi and the ithbat, the affirmation and the negation, which is totally different to what I'm going to mention. But three important points have to be there. The first one is knowledge. And so if the person comes with knowledge, what happens? He gets saved from the path of who? The Christians, who act with no knowledge. That's very important. So if you know what La ilaha illallah means, you're saved from the path of the Christians who believe in Trinity but have no knowledge. They just argue what they have no knowledge of. Okay, they are acting with no knowledge. The second one is actions. La ilaha illallah requires action. Okay, which saves you from the path of the Jews. Because the Jews, they have knowledge, they have understanding, but they don't act upon what they know. And the third one is as-sidq, truthfulness. And by coming with sidq, which is truthfulness, it saves you from the path of the hypocrites who pretend that they are upon La ilaha illallah, who pretend outwardly that they are from the Muslims, but in reality, they are hypocrites. What they are hiding in their hearts is different to what they are showing. What they are hiding in their hearts is greater even than what they are showing us. With those three points, inshallah ta'ala, if you keep it with you, you'll be successful, inshallah ta'ala, in your course and in your life when it comes to La ilaha illallah. So if you've not benefited from this entire lecture or series I've done, just remember those three points. Knowledge that saves you from the path of the Christians. Because the Christians, they have no knowledge. They act upon what they don't know. And the second one is action. And the action saves you from the path of the Jews, who know but don't act upon what they know. And the third one is as-sidq, truthfulness. And truthfulness saves you from the path of the hypocrites. Because what the hypocrites do is they outwardly portray themselves as to be Muslimin, muwahideen, but internally they believe kufr and shirk and etc. Okay, brothers and sisters, that's a very important point, inshallah ta'ala. So now I'm going to go through the nullifiers and the things that nullify la ilaha illallah. Okay, and now when I mention these nullifiers, brothers and sisters, we're not looking at an external being, an external people. Everybody, inshallah ta'ala, when you study these nawaqif, look at yourself. I myself included. I'm thinking about myself. I'm being conscious of my own self. Am I falling into any of these? I'm worried for my own self. And how can I stay away from these nullifiers? Okay, the first one is ashirku. It is to associate partners with Allah in ibadah. That nullifies your la ilaha illallah automatically. Okay? Ashirku fi ibadatillah. If you associate partners with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala in ibadah, it nullifies your la ilaha illallah. Qala ta'ala, Allah says in the Qur'an, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّهُ مَن يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارُ وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ. And from the things, brothers and sisters, that is considered an act which can nullify your la ilaha illallah that falls under shirk is dua al amwati wal istighatha to bihim, calling on to the dead, doing istighatha to the dead, wal nadhr wal dhabh lahum, slaughtering for them, taking oaths and vows for them, and things like that. These will nullify your la ilaha illallah. Your la ilaha illallah will go, it won't be there anymore. Ash-shirk. If you look at the two ayahs that I mentioned, the first verse, it says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَغْفِرُ أَن يُشْرَكَ بِهِ. Allah does not forgive a person who associate partners with him. So you have to remember that. You're not forgiven. If you associate partners with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, you're not forgiven. وَيَغْفِرُ مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. But Allah forgives anyone who is other than that. يعني وَيَغْفِرُ, Allah forgives, مَا دُونَ ذَلِكَ, anything besides that. But who does he do it for? لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ, whoever will, he will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He says, إِنَّهُ مَنْ يُشْرِكْ بِاللَّهِ, anyone who associates partners with Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, فَقَدْ حَرَّمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ الْجَنَّةِ, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He has prohibited Jannah from them. وَمَأْوَاهُ النَّارِ, and the hellfire is His final abode. وَمَا لِلظَّالِمِينَ مِنْ أَنصَارِ, and the wrongdoers and the criminals, they don't have anyone giving them victory. Okay? The second, inshallah ta'ala, is مَنْ جَعَلَ بَيْنَهُ وَبَيْنَ اللَّهِ وَصَائِطَ يَدْعُوهُمْ. Anyone who places between him and Allah, he places intermediaries. He asks them. Yani calls on to them. وَيَسْأَلُهُمْ, he asks them. الشَّفَاعَ, intercession. وَيَتَوَكَّلُ عَلَيْهِمْ, he relies on them. Then this person, كَفَرَ إِجْمَعًا, by unanimous agreement, with no difference of opinion, he's a disbeliever. قَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah says in the Qur'an, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ. Allah says, وَيَعْبُدُونَ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ مَا لَا يَضُرُّهُمْ وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ. وَيَقُولُونَ هَؤُلَاءِ شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ قُلْ أَتُنَبِّئُونَ اللَّهَ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Allah says, وَيَعْبُدُونَ, they worship, مِنْ دُونِ اللَّهِ, besides Allah, مَا لَا يَضُرُّونَ, that which cannot harm them, وَلَا يَنْفَعُهُمْ, and that cannot benefit them, وَيَقُولُونَ, and they say, هَؤُلَاءِ, these which we are worshipping, شُفَعَاؤُنَا عِنْدَ اللَّهِ, they are our intercessors. Okay? قُلْ, say to them, أَتُنَبِّئُونَ اللَّهَ بِمَا لَا يَعْلَمُ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَلَا فِي الْأَرْضِ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى. The third, inshallah ta'ala, is مَنْ لَمْ يُكَفِّرِ الْمُشْرِكِينَ أَوْ شَكَّ فِي كُفْرِهِمْ أَوْ صَحَحَ مَذْهَبَهُمْ. The person who justifies the actions of the mushrikeen, he justifies their actions. He justifies the action of the mushrikeen, those who associate partners with Allah. He justifies it. Or shakka fi kufrim, or he even doubts their kufr. Says, I don't know. There's a difference of opinion in this issue. Or sahaha madhabahum, or he justifies their methodology and their belief. Kafara, he becomes a disbeliever. The fourth one is من اعتقد أن هدي غير النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أكمل من هديه أو أن حكم غيري أحسن من حكمي. Or any individual who believes, okay, this person believes, anna hadya ghayra an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam akmalu min hadiyin, that there is a way of life better than the way that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has sanctioned. Yani there is a way better, a lifestyle better than the one that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was upon. Okay? Or anna hukma ghayri ahsanu min hukmihi, or they believe that the judgments that the Prophet passed alayhi salatu wasalam, they believe there are rules and regulations that have been set by other people other than the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which are better than that which the Prophet mentioned. And what the Prophet said here, yani this constitution or this article is better than it. كَالَّذِينَ يُفَضِّلُونَ حُكْمَ الطَّوَاغِيْتِ عَلَى حُكْمِي سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى, like those people who give superiority, they give the upper hand to man-made laws over the law of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. They choose those laws over the law of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Okay? They give tafdeel, they give virtue to it. They say it's better. As Allah mentioned in the Qur'an, أَفَحُكْمَ الْجَاهِلِيَةِ يَبَغُونَ وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ مِنَ اللَّهِ حُكْمَ لِقَوْمٍ يُقِنُونَ. Do they give virtue and superiority, okay, to these laws that they've made over the law of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala and His Messenger? The fifth one is, مَنْ أَبْغَضَ شَيْئًا مِمَّا جَاءَ بِهِ الرَّسُولُ وَلَوْ عَمِلَ بِهِ فَقَدْ كَفَرَ. Anyone who dislikes that which the Messenger came with, something the Messenger came with, alayhi salatu wasalam, this person dislikes it. Even if he acts upon that thing, and he does it, but he doesn't like it, that person is a disbeliever. As Allah said in the ayah, ذَلِكَ بِأَنَّهُمْ كَرِهُوا مَا أَنزَلَ اللَّهُ فَأَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالَهُمْ. That is because they disliked what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has set down. فَأَحْبَطَ أَعْمَالَهُمْ, and their actions have become nullified. The sixth one is, مَنِ اسْتَهَزَأَ بِشَيْءٍ مِّن دِينِ الرَّسُولِ. Anybody who mocks a matter that has come to us through the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, يعني a matter in the religion, they mock it. أو ثوابي, or they mock the reward that's connected to it. أو عقابه, or they mock the punishment that's going to be from those people. They mock the punishment. Like for example, some people who mock the reward that's mentioned for the shuhada, the virgins that have been promised for the shuhada. You see some Muslims mocking this. What you need to remember, kafara, they become disbelievers by doing that. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Quran, قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِهِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَدِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. لَا تَعْتَدِرُوا, don't look for excuses. You have become disbelievers after your iman. How can we hold a people and keep them within Islam if Allah tabarak wa ta'ala took them out? We can't. If Allah chose to take you out, there's no way we can keep you in. And this is something that needs to be understood a lot. There are many people mocking matters of the religion and they think it's a joke. On social media, it's a joke. I was only joking, I didn't really mean it. What did these people say? Nah, they were also saying, when they were asked, قُلْ أَبِاللَّهِ وَآيَاتِ وَرَسُولِهِ كُنْتُمْ تَسْتَهْزِئُونَ لَا تَعْتَدِرُوا قَدْ كَفَرْتُمْ بَعْدَ إِيمَانِكُمْ. Their argument was what? إِنَّمَا كُنَّا نَخُوضُ وَنَلْعَبُ. We were only joking, we were playing. We didn't really mean it. Did Allah tabarak wa ta'ala accept that from them? No. They became kuffar. Because mocking the religion of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, mocking it itself is kufr. بغض النظر. We don't look at what your heart meant, and no, the action itself, this action alone can take you null and void your religion. Allahu Akbar. So many people need to fear Allah what they joke about when it comes to these religious issues of our deen. The seventh is as-sihr, magic. Magic, brothers and sisters, magicians are not Muslims. They are kuffar. Whether their magic is as-sarf wal-atf, whether there is to separate two people or to bring two people together, yani they say, oh, we only did this magic because this man didn't want to stay with the woman. So the woman went and she looked for a magician. And the magician, now what he did is kept these two people together. Look, this magician didn't do something bad. He kept two people together. Nope. فَمَنْ فَعَلَوْ, anyone who does it, أَوْ رَضِيَ بِهِ, or is pleased for that shirk, that act of shirk, which is sihr, then kafara, he's a disbeliever. And the evidence to that is قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, the statement of Allah, وَمَا يُعَلِّمَانِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ حَتَّى يَقُولَا إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ فِتْنَةٌ فَلَا تَكْفُرُ. That فَلَا تَكْفُرُ is what concerns us. Don't become disbelievers. And then sihr, what does it do? It makes a person a disbeliever. Okay? ولذلك, it's not allowed. If someone does magic to you, okay, you're not allowed to do magic to remove the magic. You're not allowed to. It's not allowed. We'll speak about that, inshallah ta'ala, in other places. The eighth one is mudaharatul mushrikeen wa mu'awanatum ala al-muslimin, aiding the disbelievers, supporting the disbelievers over the Muslims. Also, this renders your Islam null and void, takes you out of the fold of Islam. You're no longer considered a Muslim anymore. And the evidence for that is qawluhu ta'ala, the statement of Allah, وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ مِنْكُمْ فَإِنَّهُ مِنْهُمْ. Anyone who takes them as an ally, anyone who takes them, وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّهُمْ مِنْكُمْ, anyone from amongst you who takes these people as allies, فَإِنَّهُ مِنْهُمْ, for verily he is from them. إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَهْدِي الْقَوْمَ الظَّالِمِينَ. Verily Allah does not guide the ظالمين. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, he doesn't. Allah won't guide them, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Again, as I said before, a people, Allah chose to take them out of the religion. Allah chose to expel them out of this deen. How can we come and then try to bring them? We can't. We can't bring them into the religion. We believe what Allah said. We believe what the Messenger said. The ninth is, مَنْ اَعْتَقَدَ أَنَّ بَعْضَ النَّاسِ يَسَعَهُ الْخُرُوجُ عَنْ شَرِيعَةِ مُحَمَّدٍ فَوَ كَافِرٌ. The ninth one is, anyone who believes that some of the people have the rights, it's their choice. They're allowed to leave the religion of Islam if they want to. If you want to leave Islam, you can. It's your choice. You can leave it. And we don't mean it from the perspective of law-wise. If they're in a country, the country allows them, we can't do anything about that. But we don't believe what these people are doing is wrong. So we believe what these people are doing is wrong. We believe what these people are doing is a crime within Islam. We believe what they are doing is displeasing to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. We believe within Islam, this is a very serious act. And we believe there's no religion that's accepted. Only Al-Islam. Every other way of life, null and void, has no value. So we don't believe in any way, shape or form that there is anyone who has rights to come into Islam and leave it. You have no choice to leave Islam. You have to stay within Islam. Because that's the only accepted religion to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Allah ta'ala, Allah says in the Qur'an, وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْهُ وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Anyone who tries to look for a religion in other Islam, Allah won't accept it from them. And that person is going to be from the people who are destroyed. Okay, brothers and sisters. So in other words, we will never feel, do you want to take Christianity? No problem. You want to take Islam? No problem. You want to take Buddhism? No problem. You know what they say? Rivers, lakes, seas, different names, all contain water. All religions, different names, all contain the truth. There are all different ways to get to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So no problem. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. We don't believe that. We believe Islam only. وَمَنْ يَبْتَغِ غَيْرَ الْإِسْلَامِ دِينًا فَلَنْ يُقْبَلَ مِنْ. If you try to look for a religion other than Islam as a religion, Allah won't accept it from you. وَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. And you are the day of judgment from those who are destroyed. The tenth and final one, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to mention is al-i'raad an deenillah. It is to turn away from the religion of Allah. La yata'allamu, the person doesn't want to learn it. Wa la ya'malu bihi, and doesn't want to act upon it. You see that a lot. There's a Muslim, his name is Muhammad, by name faqat. He's never studied Islam. He doesn't know anything about Islam. Okay? And he doesn't act upon it at all. Nothing from Islam. He doesn't know anything from Islam. No knowledge of Islam and doesn't act upon it. Fully turns away from it when there are local masjids around his area and everything. He chooses not to learn it. This is a type of kufr. It's called kufr al-i'rad. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said about these people, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُنْتَقِمُونَ. Who's worse then? Allah said, وَمَنْ أَظْلَمُ مِمَّنْ ذُكِّرَ بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِ. The verses of Allah are mentioned. And there's masajids and there's everything around him. The verse of Allah have been mentioned. The deen of Allah, he turns away from it. He ignores it. He doesn't want to hear it. ثُمَّ أَعْرَضَ عَنْهَا, and he turns away from it. إِنَّا مِنَ الْمُجْرِمِينَ مُنْتَقِمُونَ. These 10 that I just mentioned, brothers and sisters, they will nullify your kalimatu tawheed. They will nullify your la ilaha illallah. Anyone who falls into any one of them, وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ, may Allah protect each and every one of us from it. Your tawheed will be nullified. Your iman will be destroyed. Your la ilaha illallah will not benefit you. The scholars have mentioned all of these 10 and more in their works, and they are all agreed upon. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bimannihi wa karamihi. I ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to protect us. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, all of us, na'udhu billahi min mujibati ghadabihi wa alimi iqabihi. Wa nas'aluhu subhanahu an yuwaffiqana jami'an lima yurdihi. Wa an yahdiyana wa jami'al muslimina siratahul mustaqim. Innahu sami'un mujibun qareeb. Subhanaka Allahumma bihamdihi. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayhi.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.